Language lives on the tongues of the people who use it. Many believe that Aotearoa's children will not repeat the ancient phrases their ancestors used in reverence. They believe that the white wave of power and control has overwhelmed the song of Māori language. Nurture the seed and it will blossom. There will be a rebellion. Māori will resurface. Strength is found in numbers, knowledge and ambition. The strength of Māori will reclaim the language. The world will acknowledge the uprising of Māori. Māori will not forget the words buried deep in their hearts and lingering on the tips of their tongues. Words waiting to be savoured, rolled around the mouth, explored, immersed, and once again made a dominant feature of Aotearoa. Faith plants the seed, love makes it sprout. Tōku reo, tōku oho oho. My language, my awakening. North Scotland, aho. I am the blue and green tartan of a swaying kilt that rests underneath the claymore of the bloodied hand of MacDonald. North Scandinavia, aho. I am a proud Viking, steering my dragon ship and navigating the seas, rallying my Norse kinsmen to arms. North England, aho. I am a bowman, an archer, standing strong in the forest of Nottingham. North Aotearoa, aho. I am a child of Papatūānuku, originating from the womb of our whenua and singing the waiata of karakia and tikanga. I am descended from powerful leaders who help support me through my journey and encourage me to do the right thing. They help me pursue the language of Aotearoa and embrace the culture that is all of us. Plant the seeds and produce a garden. Looking at the trend of population increase and decrease from the 2016 census, the current demographics of ethnicity of Aotearoa's population show that there are higher percentages of Māori in the younger age groups and a larger proportion of Pākehā in the older age group. There will be a population increase of Māori and a huge decrease of Pākehā in the population. The majority will be found in the brown arms holding up the culture of Aotearoa and the multicoloured legs supporting the body of Māori. Water the seed and it will grow. When I was three, I travelled over the small expanse of sea between us and Australia to start a new life. I did not experience what Māori culture or language was before I left. I learnt in a country that considered the indigenous people to be unimportant and their language insignificant. Australia's Aboriginals did not have any power in their country. Their government did not hear them, and their languages were almost and practically extinct. That's why when I was eight and I moved back to New Zealand and saw these proud and powerful people called Māori who had their language interwoven into society's vocabulary and their culture affecting the surrounding people's actions, I was awed. But as my time in Aotearoa lengthened, I became aware that there was more than just a strong men and women standing for their roots and for their rights. There was also an underlying sense of restriction. Restriction in Māori culture's availability to be dived into in depth. Restriction in language, as the amount of people who could speak Te Reo fluently was not a large amount. The roots of the seed digs deep into the earth. When the population statistics change and Māori are once again at large, the teachers of Te Reo and the children learning the language will be the leaders of our whenua. The Māori language dripping off their tongues, and Māori culture dominating their ways. It takes just over 2 decades, and then the reo will be there to pick up what once fell slack and tighten the bonds between the tangata and tupuna of Aotearoa. The stem from the seed grows tall and strong. I was once told that I did not matter in Aotearoa because I was white, that I would never be enough because I would not have my land's rightful owners at my back. So me being me, I set off to do something about it. I took up kapahaka, got to know the people I was studying, learned how to pronounce the Māori dialect in a new way with each place we moved to. As I got older and experienced more of Te Reo Māori, I discovered I was fascinated with it, completely infatuated with the people and their language. I believe that my passion for Māori will spread, that society will be converted and will fight for my cause. My craving to learn more will spread as a hunger to reach the starting line of your Māori language life journey. All of Aotearoa will become part of a cause to enrich Te Reo Māori and bring up the language. All the flowers of all the tomorrows are in the seeds of today. I welcome you all to embrace this language and see for yourselves firsthand what I have experienced, the strength and beauty of Māori, the mana and welcoming that gushes forth from the reo like rain from the sky. Māori language will once again become a dominant part of Aotearoa, because soon there will be a million speakers of Māori. So ask yourself, will you be part of the million? Thank you.